Our kidneys are amazing. They begin to grow well before we are born and are completely developed before we take our first breath. Their main functions are to keep a careful balance of salts and water and eliminate toxins which could poison the body. Our circulating blood is cleaned by passing through tiny filters in the kidney. Imagine draining your pasta in a large colander, separating the pasta from the excess water. Our kidneys allow water and small molecules to pass through, but keep cells and large molecules in the circulation. There are about 1 million filters, or glomeruli, in each human kidney. If we take Max, a healthy 70kg adult, his glomerular filtration rate is about 125 mL per minute, or a small glass of wine. In one single day, his kidneys filter an incredible 180,000 millilitres, or 180 litres. That's the equivalent of 240 bottles of wine. Fortunately, Max doesn't produce this much urine because each filter is connected to its own long, winding tube that absorbs water and small molecules to keep an overall balance in the body. The final waste fluid then flows to the centre of the kidney and then down into the bladder. Max's final urine volume is a much more manageable 1 to 2 litres per day, depending on how much he drinks and how much other fluid is lost from the body in other ways, such as sweating. In addition to making urine, our kidneys control blood pressure. They help to keep our bones healthy by processing vitamin D, and they produce a hormone called erythropoietin, or EPO, which is needed to make red blood cells. Of course, all these incredible functions happen without most of us sparing them a second thought, but in a growing number of people with chronic kidney disease, these important kidney functions are missing. Kidney disease can occur at any age, but it is more common as we get older. By the time we reach 65, 1 in 4 people are likely to have kidney disease. In some people, the kidneys eventually fail and they require dialysis to help their bodies to keep the right balance. A better alternative to dialysis is a new kidney, a transplant from a donor who has the right match of blood and tissue proteins. An early sign of kidney disease is the presence of blood cells or protein in the urine. This is usually not visible by eye, but can be picked up with a simple urine dipstick test. The blood and protein usually leak from the tiny filters. In Manchester, we are studying these tiny filters in detail to work out how they stay healthy, how they are damaged in kidney disease, and how we can help to repair them. My name is Rebecca and I'm an academic foundation doctor based in the Wellcome Trust Centre for Cell Matrix Research at the University of Manchester.